Hello learners, welcome back to my channel Shraddha's Physics. In this part we will see the eigenfunctions and eigenvalues, and that after we will discuss on the degeneracy. Now first of all start, what is the eigenfunction and what are the eigenvalues? So if psi is a well behaved function, it is a well behaved function, then an operator, so that operator may be, so let us take here the operator is suppose q cap may operate, it will operate on the state function, that is it will operate on the function psi in two different ways depending on the nature of the function, depending on the nature of the function psi. So now first of all you can see here the function is your psi. And the function, that is the, here you will consider the operator is your q cap, and the operator q cap, it will operate on the psi in the two different ways. So now first of all, so the first one is, if I will write here, so the operator q cap operating on the function psi may change the function into another function phi. That is, we can write q cap psi, that is equal to phi, where this phi is linearly independent on psi. Phi is linearly independent on psi. That is, this is the first way how the operator can operate on the function psi. That is, first of all, if we will operate this q cap on the state function psi, then it will give the phi, that is the another wave function. And here, this psi is called the eigenfunction. This is called the eigenfunction. And the operator, that is this q cap, this is called the operator. Okay. And here, this is your another state function. Okay, this phi is another state function. Now the second one, the operator q cap operating on some function psi may leave the function unchanged, may leave the function unchanged but with a complex or real multiple. That is, if the operator q cap here, when it will operate on the function psi, then it will give equal to psi, that is the same function psi with a multiple of the lambda. That is, this lambda may be a real or complex number, where lambda may be a real or complex number. And this lambda is called the eigenvalue, and that is called the eigenvalue. And here the psi is called the eigenfunction, and here the psi equal to the eigenfunction. And here you should note that here in this case, when the operator is q cap, when it will operate on the state function psi, then it will give the eigenvalue of this operator q cap. Okay, that is, it will give the eigenvalue of that operator, because if I will say this q cap is the position operator, that is, when this position operator will operate on this state function psi, then the value, that is the lambda, will give the eigenvalue of the position operator. When this q cap is your energy, then this energy operator, when it will operate on the state function psi, then the eigenvalue that you will get, that is the eigenvalue of the energy operator, and so on. So in these two ways, the operator can operate. That is, first of all, when this q cap operator will operate on the state function psi, it will give another wave function, that is phi. But when this q cap operator, it will operate on the psi, in the second case, it will give the same function, same eigenfunction psi, with a real or complex multiple. Okay. So now let us see the eigenvalue spectrum. So what is the eigenvalue spectrum? The collection of all eigenvalues of an operator q cap is called its spectrum. Okay, and if the operator has discrete eigenvalues, it has discrete eigenvalues, that is lambda 1, lambda 2, and so on up to lambda n, then it has discrete spectra. And similarly, on the other hand, if it has eigenvalues, running through a continuous range of values, then that is called the continuous spectra. So basically, in case of the eigenvalue spectrum, all the collection of the eigenvalues of an operator q cap, it is called the spectrum. And there are two types of the spectrum may be observed. It may be discrete or it may be continuous. Okay, if it has the discrete eigenvalues like lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda n, and so on, then it has the discrete spectrum. When it is continuous in nature, that is, it has the same eigenvalue, then that is called the continuous spectra. That is, simply, if I will give the example, suppose an operator is q cap, and when it will operate, suppose some wave function psi 1, then it will give, suppose, lambda 1 psi 1. And again, this same operator, when it will operate on the wave function, suppose psi 2, then suppose it will give the eigenvalue, suppose lambda 2 psi 2. And so on, when this q cap will operate on the wave function psi n, it will give, suppose, lambda n and psi n. So here you can see the different eigenvalues. So in this case, you will get the discrete spectra. Here you will get the discrete spectra. But when this lambda 1 is same as lambda, and this lambda 2 is same as lambda, and also up to the n number of lambda, you will get the same eigenvalue, that is lambda. Then in that case, we can say that you will get the continuous spectra. When all the eigenvalues are same, then you will get the continuous spectra. Now we will see what is degeneracy. The number of eigenfunctions, eigenfunctions corresponding to a given eigenvalue determines the degree of degeneracy of that eigenvalue. Suppose if I'll consider the same operator QK, that is, as we have just seen that the eigenvalue spectrum in that case. So similarly, if I'll consider if all the eigenfunctions, if all the eigenfunctions that is psi1, psi2 and so on correspond to distinctly different eigenvalues, the eigenspectrum is called the non-degenerate. The eigenspectrum is non-degenerate. So in case of non-degenerate means here, just a minute, non-degenerate. So non-degenerate means it has the different eigenvalue. So for example, if I will write, suppose the operator is QK, when it will operate on the psi1, then it will give, suppose, lambda1, psi1. Suppose the operator is QK, again it will operate on the psi2, suppose it will give the lambda2, psi2, and so on. When it will operate on the Q cap, will operate on the wave function psi n, then it will give lambda n psi n. So in this case, you can see here the eigenvalues, that is lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3 and so on up to the lambda n, you have the different eigenvalues, then that spectrum is called the non-degenerate in nature. Okay. Now the next is, if more than one eigenfunctions correspond to the same eigenvalue, same eigenvalue of the operator Q cap, then the eigenspectrum of the operator, that is Q cap is degenerate. That is, here you have considered, suppose it is your Q cap and it will operate on the function psi1, then it will give lambda psi1, that is the eigenvalue lambda, and again if you will operate on the Q cap psi2, it will give the same eigenvalue, that is lambda psi2, and so on. If the Q cap will operate for the psi n, then it will give the same eigenvalue lambda with the psi n. So here in this case, when you will get the same eigenvalue, that is called degenerate spectrum, but when you will get the different eigenvalue, then you will get non-degenerate spectrum. Okay. Now let us take one example so that you can get a clear idea about the degenerate and non-degenerate, or the degeneracy or non-degeneracy, you can check. Suppose for example, the question is, in a given system, the energy eigenvalues corresponding to the correspond to the eigenfunction, correspond to the eigenfunction. So here the eigenfunctions, let us take psi 1, psi 2, psi 3 and so on up to suppose psi 14, are the energy's values are suppose E1 equal to minus 13.6 electron volt, E2 equal to E3 equal to E4 equal to E5, and that is suppose the energy's values are minus 3.4 eV, and E6 equal to E7, and that is equal to E8 equal to E9 equal to E10 and up to equal to E11 equal to E12, that is equal to E13 and that is equal to E14, and suppose it has the value minus 1.5 electron volt. Now the question is, each the energy spectrum is the energy spectrum continuous or discrete? First question is, it is continuous or discrete, you have to check. And the next is, you have to check whether it is degenerate or non-degenerate. And therefore, the next is, you have to calculate the determine the degree of, then you have to determine the degree of degeneracy, if any. Okay, now here from this question you can see here there are two. Here is the first year, E1 is one energy level, it has the value minus 13.6 eV, but here there are four energy levels, that is E2, E3, E4 and E5, they all have the same eigenvalue, that is same value, that is your minus 3.4, and the rest from E6 to E14, they have the same eigenvalue, that is your minus 1.5. So first of all, you can see for the eigenvalue, let me show you. For this first E1 state, if I will say E1 equal to minus 13.6 eV, so here I can write, so this energy level E1, for this E1 equal to minus 13.6 eV, it is your non-degenerate state. Okay, this is your non-degenerate state. And the next is, when you can see here, the E2, E3, E4 and E5, they all four have the same eigenvalue, that is your minus 3.4. So that is, when they have the same eigenvalue, we know this is your degenerate, that is from E2 to E2 equal to E3 equal to E4 and that is equal to E5, and they all have the energy value, that is your minus 3.4 eV. So here we can say that this is your degenerate state, or it will give the degenerate spectrum. And there are four energy level which has the same eigenvalue. There are four energy level, that is E2, E3, E4 and E5. There are four energy level which has the same eigenvalue. That's why it can be called as, it is four-fold degenerate. It is called four-fold degenerate. And that is the degree of, we can say that the degree of degeneracy is 4. Okay, the degree of degeneracy, that is equal to 4. In this way, we can also write, this is four-fold degenerate, or this is your degree of degeneracy equal to 4. Now the next is, you can see here, E6 equal to E7 and up to E14, that is equal to minus 1.5 eV. So now if I will write, this is your E6 equal to E7, that is equal to E8 equal to E9 equal to E10 equal to, and so on, that is equal to E14, and that value is equal to minus 1.5 eV. Now you can, if I will calculate 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, this is your E11, E12, and here it is E13. There are total 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So there are 9 energy levels which have the same eigenvalue, that is your minus 1.5 eV. So here we can say that this is, first of all, this is your degenerate state. Okay. And here in this case, we can say this is your degenerate and this is your 9-fold degenerate. This is your 9-fold degenerate, or this is called the degree of degeneracy is here 9. Okay. And here, if I will discuss about the continuous and discrete, you can see here, this they all have, that is E2, E3, E4, E5, they all have the same eigenvalue. It means that it is continuous in nature. And if I will say for this total energy level, it is continuous in nature. But if I will see as a whole, they are in the discrete form. So as a whole, we can say that for the total system, so it is discrete. Okay, the energy spectrum will be discrete. And also, you can represent like which one is your non-degenerate and which one is your degenerate, and the degree of degeneracy you can calculate in this way. Okay, so this is all for today. Still, if you have any doubt, can ask me in the comment section. Thank you all.